Hello guys, this is Eugenio Solis de Bando, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can convert this wireframe in a real mockup using Photoshop CC 2019. And then on the following video, I'm going to show you how you can convert this on HTML and CSS using Dreamweaver 2019. All right, let's start. Alright guys, I already created this wireframe using Photoshop. You can watch that video on this channel. I'm going to put on the comment below the link to. What I would like to do with this wireframe, I would like to convert on a real mockup. I'm going to import images, I'm going to work with different fonts, with colors and other stuff. But first, what I would like to do, I would like to show you how you can improve the alignment. I'm going to show you a few features using Photoshop. All right, let's start. First, I'm going to increase the size of my window. I'm going to zoom in, and here, what I would like to do, I would like to work with columns, okay? Like, for example, when you work in InDesign, that you can create columns. If you design a magazine, you can create columns, and also on web is pretty helpful to work with columns. How you can do that? If you go to the View menu, here you can select New Guide Layout, okay? With this option, you will see it's going to display all these columns that you have here. But if you have more than one artboard, okay, you will see on the entire canvas. What you can do here, you can select instead the target, the canvas, okay? You can select all artboard that will divide the same artboard. Here you will have 8 columns and here 8 columns. But if you want different, what you can do is you can just select, for example, I'm going to select just the desktop and I will like 8 columns. Okay, and here you can increase the amount of columns. If you want to adapt, okay, all these rectangle, can you see on this column, for example, I'm going to work with 10 columns. I like to work with 12 columns. Okay, but in this case, I would like to work with them because I can align properly all these elements that I have here. All right, then you can put the gutter. But here I'm working in inches, okay? I would like to work with pixels. This document, before I go there, one of the things how you can change to pixels. If you go to the View menu, I'm going to select Ruler, okay? And then you can right-click over the ruler, and instead inches, you can select pixels. Okay, and then next time that you go here to the View, if you go select New Guide Layout, what's going to happen? You will have pixels instead. Just double check that. If you already have pixels, that is good. All right, I'm going to select again the desktop. Okay, I'm going to put here 10 columns. All right. Also, you can work with rows if you want. You can add different rows if you can separate on different sections. For example, I'm going to put one section here. Okay, but in this case, I would like to work without rows. Okay, and then if you click OK, you will have the columns there. Every time that you click, okay, look at this. I have this tool selected, okay, the Move tool. I'm going to click here. You can see the columns, all right? And then you can zoom here. I can select this element, okay, and then I can start moving, trying to adapt, okay, with the guide. I'm going to use, for example, this, and I would like to adapt every single placeholder to the same size. Okay, I can do the same with the text, okay? But I am trying to show you the idea of what you can do with the columns, okay? And it's pretty helpful to work with, okay? And then ultimately I have a snap, okay? If that is difficult, you can zoom in. All right, Command 0 or Control 0 on the PC if you want to see the entire thing, okay? And I'm gonna zoom. And I can do the same with the others, okay? I can do manually with the arrows on my keyboard. Okay, I'm going to increase the size of this. Okay, and then you can select text and so on. All right, the other thing that I would like to do, I would like to show you my process if I want to use a grid. Okay, and for example, I'm going to remove the columns. You can go here to the View. Okay, and here, if you go, you can select here, Clear Guides. Okay, and then you can remove all the columns. All right, but how you can work with a grid? That is another thing. If I go to the View again, okay, you can select Show, and then you can select Grid, okay? This grid is pretty helpful. It's a little difficult to see. It's a little overwhelming, but I'm gonna show you how you can improve this. Okay, let me show you. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit. Okay, everything is pretty dark, but we can change the color of the grid. We can change the increment, okay, how many grid you will see, and the separation between every single grid, okay? How you can do that? Go to the Photoshop and go to the preferences. If you're working on PC, you have to go to the edit menu, and all the way down, you will see preferences. All right, I'm gonna go to the Photoshop preferences, and here on the preferences, you can select the guides, grid, and slice, okay? I'm gonna select that, and then here on this section, you have the grid, right? First, what I would like to do, I'm gonna switch to pixels, okay? Because I don't wanna work with inches. Then, subdivision, I'm gonna show you what that happened, because look at this. For example, let's say I would like every 50 pixels, okay? I would like one grid, okay? And I would like four subdivision, or you want five, for example, you can see like every 10 pixels. Okay. I like that, but the only thing that I don't like, okay, is the color. Can you see it's too dark? What I can do here, I can click here on this patch, on this rectangle, and let's say I'm gonna put something more like a cyan, okay? But the problem is if you put something a light color, you don't see the grids between. In that case, what I like to do, I put the subdivision in just one, okay? And then instead, 10, 50, I can put, for example, 20 pixels. And then I know I have 20 pixels of separation between every single element. You can put 10, you can put whatever you want, but I'm gonna put 20, okay? I'm gonna click okay. And then if I want, for example, I can put this, okay, rectangle, okay? Which here I can see the height of that rectangle. Maybe it's a banner or it's a slider, okay? And then you know that is 440 pixels, okay, the height, okay, that is pretty good. And then you can align all the elements. And also you can continue aligning here all the elements. And if you want, okay, also you can, from the ruler, you can click and drag, okay, and you can put a guide, you can see on the grid that you want, okay, and then you will know, okay, you can align all the elements to that particular guide. Okay, you can see that is another part of the workflow that I do every time that I design a website, because then if you have the same separation between elements, your website gonna look more professional, okay? All right, I'm gonna hide the grid to continue showing you different tips and tricks, okay? I'm gonna go here to the show, and then you can deselect the grid. All right, that is another thing. The only thing that I like to do if I design a website, okay, is working with the images. Let me show you. I'm gonna go to my desktop, and here on my desktop, I have this folder, okay, and this folder is the images that I download for a website that I use pretty often. This website, I'm gonna go to my Google Chrome, and I'm gonna put here pexels.com, okay? I recommend you this website because from here you can download free images and you can use even for commercial use. For example, I'm gonna select ski, okay, I'm gonna enter. Okay, let's say this is the topic of my website. And for example, this is one of the images that I selected. If you click here, you can see the photographer, but you can free to download. And look at this, it's free for personal and commercial use. You have to read everything about the license, okay? Try to take a look, try to read, okay, in order to do everything correctly, okay? But I'm gonna use this picture, looks pretty cool, okay? And you can download many different pictures from this website. The only thing that you can do instead to download from that website, you can use, for example, a stock image, okay? If you want to buy images, there are many different stock images. For example, Adobe Stock Images, okay, is a service that is pretty cool. You can go to the stock at that adobe.com, or you can go to the images 123rf.com. There are many different websites, okay, and this one comes with a lot of different images that you can use in your project. But the thing is, Adobe is something that is pretty cool, okay? You have Adobe stock images in one panel. Look at here. Here, this is my library panel. Okay, so you can search Adobe stock. I can put my mouse here. I'm gonna search, for example, ski. Okay, and immediately, without press enter, you have all these images. See, it's pretty cool. And for example, let's say you want, for example, this image. You can just click, drag, and drop, okay, directly in Photoshop, and now the image is there. Okay, this is gonna create a smart object. I'm gonna create, just click OK. All right, and then you have the image there. It's that simple. And then if I select the image, you can see here on my layers, okay, I'm gonna and double click here on the color panel in order to have more space. Okay, I'm gonna move this up to show you more the images. All right, and then you can see there is your image. Okay, if I click here, you can select the edit the content, you can embed, you can buy these images from here. Okay, see, that is pretty cool from Adobe. All right, and then if you want to delete the image, you just select here and then press the delete key, you will delete the image. If you prefer to not use the Adobe stock image, okay, one other thing that you can do, you can use the images that you download from Pexel. Now let's go back again to my images that I have here on my desktop. I'm gonna open these images. All right, and here I have all these images with that name. The only thing, I don't like to use this name, okay? In that case, I'm gonna show you what you can do with Adobe Bridge. I have a few videos about Adobe Bridge on this channel that you can see how you can work with Adobe Bridge. And I like to use Adobe Bridge for all my projects. I'm gonna increase the thumbnail here, okay? And then I can click, for example, on the image that I want. I can hit the space bar. You can see the image in full screen. There are many things that I can do here in Adobe Bridge. You can add rating, okay? You can see the metadata, you can filter, many different things. But the thing that I would like to do now, I would like to change the name of these images, okay? I'm gonna select everything. And then here from the tools menu, you have batch rename. If I select that, for example, here you have the project, the date create, you can see many different things. I'm gonna delete a few criteria because I don't need this. For example, I don't need the underscore, I don't need the date. The only thing that I would like to do, I would like this in my project that is ski, okay? And then a sequence number of, let's say just 2 digits, okay? I don't plan to place more than 100 images. And then if you want to type text, no, I don't need this. Just ski and serial number, and then just select rename. Double check how key rename in the same folder. I'm gonna select rename. All right, and now you can see a very good name for this image. Then if I click here in Photoshop, and then I'm gonna go back to Adobe Bridge, what you can do, you can just move Adobe Bridge, and then if you want one of these images, for example, this one, you can just drag and drop that images, and then it's directly there. Okay, I'm gonna zoom out, okay, with my magnifying glass, and then I can go here to the edit, and can select, for example, transform, and then I can scale that image, all right? If you continue scaling the image like this. By the way, if you are working on Photoshop CC 2019, you don't have to hold down the shift key while you are transforming, because now automatically Photoshop CC 2019, okay, will scale proportionally the image, all right? I'm gonna zoom in, okay? And I like how this image looks like. Sometimes when you place the image, you will see the image will adapt to the size of the rectangle. You can change that on the preferences. I'm gonna go to the preferences again, general, okay? And here I have this thing that I disconnect, this resize image during place, okay? It's very important. I'm gonna select that to show you what happened, because if I click okay, and then let's say I would like to place the same image here, I'm gonna go to my Adobe Bridge. I'm gonna just drag and drop this image there, and you can see automatically will adapt to the height, okay? Not the width, because it will fill the frame proportionally with the image. It's whatever you prefer. And then I'm gonna select the other images. For example, I'm gonna put all these images here. You can just drag and drop all this. I'm gonna put this other one. Okay, go back to Adobe Bridge. I'm gonna put this one here. You can see, and it's pretty cool the way that you can place all your images, creating your pretty nice mockup. Okay, I'm gonna drag and drop this one, and then I'm gonna go and put these last two ones here on the bottom part. And of course, then you can do the same on the other mockup. Then, what about the fonts? Okay, it's another thing that I like to work with different fonts. If you are working with fonts, there are many different websites that you can download fonts. For example, one of the websites that I like to use is dafont.com. On this website, you can download many different fonts for your project. You can download for free, you can use it for free for non-commercial use. But no, today, instead to use Adobe fonts, I'm gonna use the Google fonts. If you just search Google fonts, automatically you will see the first hit is fonts.google.com. What is the advantage of this? If you want to use any of these fonts, for example, I'm gonna take a look to all the fonts that I have here. Let's say you want to use, let's say the Happy Monkey. All right, I would like to see this one. I'm gonna see this font. Here you can see the font. And let's say I would like to select this font, and you have two options. One option, you can download this font. Okay, if you click here, you can download the font to your desktop and you can use in your design. And also, you can use this font on your website. I mean, you can embed this font on your website, and here is the code. You will learn this, and I'm gonna use the same font. I'm gonna teach you how you can convert this mockup on HTML and CSS, and then we will use this particular font. But this time, I'm not gonna download, because I would like to use this font in Photoshop. I'm gonna select my desktop, I'm gonna save the font, and then if I close here, I'm gonna hide my Photoshop, I'm gonna go to my desktop, I'm gonna double click on this font, I have the folder there, I'm gonna double click, and there is the font, okay? If you see here, this file, okay, will talk about the OpenFOIL license, and try to take a look to and read the permission and condition of this font. Okay, I'm gonna double click on this font, Happy Monkey, and then the only thing that you have to do is install. In Mac and PC, pretty much is the same. All right, now I have this font, and now I can use the font in Photoshop. Look at this, I'm gonna go back, all right, and then I'm gonna select, okay, for example, here I have the menu, okay, I'm gonna select all this menu, and hold on the shift, and here on my properties panel, I can select Happy Monkey to all those menu. I'm gonna select this text, okay, and I can select from here instead Arial. I'm gonna select again the Happy Monkey. I'm gonna look much better. Then let's say I'm gonna increase for 30 points, something like that. I can change the color if I want. Okay, I'm gonna select, for example, the same color that I have here on the mountains, or maybe this color right there. Okay, and you can apply something like that. All right, talking about colors, okay, how you can work with colors. We have the color panel in Photoshop. And here, you can click here and you can select many different sliders that you can use. Also, you can select the color wheel. Okay, you can see this color wheel. You can select colors. This is pretty cool to work. Okay. Also, you can work with here with the RGB slider if you want. Also, you can work here with the web color slider that you can see the sexagesimal numbers. There are many different options. But one of the options that I would like to do, okay, I would like to use. Let me go to Google Chrome and I'm gonna select here, I'm gonna type color.adobe.com, okay? This is a pretty cool website that you can create a color theme. There are many different ways to create color theme from here, okay? You have different harmonies that you can select. For example, if you select, let's say, a color, I'm gonna click here, and let's say I'm gonna move, for example, that color, all right? And then you can select different harmony, for example, monochromatic, you can select the triad, you can see complementary color, different harmonies. It's pretty cool that you can select this color theme, and on the lowest part, you have the numbers. But the only thing that you can do, you can import an image. Let's say I would like to select the same image that I have my cover, which is the Ski 04. I'm gonna select open. And automatically here, you can see the image is taking all the colors that you have on the image. And also you can start moving this if you want to select another particular color. And this looks kind of cool. For example, if you don't like this brown, okay, you can go here and select another, for example, this pretty dark color that is here, or let's say something like that. And then if you go back to the color wheel, then you will see you have all the colors here. And then if you want to vary any color, for example, this one, I would like something more lighter, I can start moving here the sliders, okay, or you can just move these little thing, or we can go all the way down. Let's say you have something with a complementary color of the color that you have there. That is another thing that you can do, you can use in your website, or I can go for something more saturated, something like that. And then if you sign in your Adobe account, okay, what you can do, you can save this in your library, okay? Here, if I show you, if I go back to Photoshop, here I can see my library, and as soon as I save this color theme, okay, you will see the color theme in your library, and if I go back to Photoshop, the color theme is there, okay? And it's pretty cool, and then if you want to add a color, for example, for the text, okay, something like that, you can select any of these colors that you have here, and you can apply to the text. Can you see? You can see how the text is changing depending on the color that you select. Can you see? That is a pretty cool option that you can create a color theme for your website. All right, that is the idea. Then I'm gonna show you in Dreamweaver how you can convert all these elements on HTML and CSS, and how you can import the size, how you can import the images, the text, and so on. All right, guys, I hope you like this video. See you on the next one. Bye. Thank you.